Nitrous oxide has probably made its reputation in the import scene thanks to the likes of the Fast and the Furious movies. But there's a little bit to know about nitrous, and it isn't quite as simple as the Fast and the Furious made out. First of all, how it works. It's essentially chemical supercharging. Nitrous oxide contains oxygen. So by injecting nitrous oxide into the engine, as it's injected, it dissociates between the nitrous and oxygen molecules, and nitrogen passes through the engine unburned. This provides more oxygen, and as long as we provide more fuel to keep the air-fuel ratio correct, it simply allows for a larger combustion event and hence more power. There's a couple of ways that we can use nitrous. First of all, it can be injected all of the time, and obviously then it increases the power. With turbocharged cars though, particularly turbocharged drag cars, we quite often see nitrous being used as a form of turbo spool aid. How this usually works is that the nitrous is only injected when the car's staging. This provides more exhaust gas energy to help spool the turbo and build boost. Once the turbo is actually on boost, the nitrous is no longer needed, and the car will actually go down the drag strip with no nitrous being injected. On the other hand, we can also employ the nitrous as the car is going down the drag strip to make additional power. However, there are some complexities around this as well, because we are creating a larger combustion event, which in turn creates more exhaust gas energy. And what we can find is that the turbocharger, or specifically the exhaust housing and turbine wheel of the turbocharger, can become restrictive, essentially not allowing that additional exhaust gas energy to flow out through the exhaust system. So we don't necessarily get the power gains that the nitrous should on paper be providing. Another consideration with nitrous is that the effectiveness of the nitrous is very dependent on the bottle pressure. Typically, we would see a target pressure of 900 psi. And on a cold day, it's unlikely we'd be anywhere near 900 psi, which is why often we see bottle heaters being employed. These are literally an electric heater or electric blanket that is strapped around the bottle, which helps heat up the bottle and therefore increase the bottle pressure. This creates a more consistent power from the nitrous when it's injected into the engine.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.